From the End of Groove Remains production team studios in the Netherlands. My name is Mix Master G and welcome to this live stream. My mission is not to sell you as many apps as I can. No, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs so you save yourself more time for the fun and creative part of being a DJ. Tonight's show will be all about a good old friend of mine, Algorithms DJ. And we are going to deep dive into some things that you need to know about Algorithms DJ. But before we do that, let's first say hi to some people in the chat. AG Flow DJ, great to see you, my friend. Things are very well here. Thank you very much. Went to see Thor, the movie, last weekend. I can highly recommend it. If you're a Bon Jovi fan, you should surely see it, but it's a great flick. Danny Doe, happy Tuesday to you too, and hope you are well too, my friend. Good to see you. Temperatures across the European continent are rather hot, which means that I am very happy that I am in an air-conditioned studio coming to you. For those of you who are unfamiliar with who I am a 55-year-old dude from the Netherlands. I had my first DJ residency at the age of 15, which means this is 40 years of DJ experience in the flesh. I am no longer an active DJ, which means I don't gig every weekend. Every now and then I do a gig, but nothing like it used to be. However, you might know me from the DJ Conversion Utility, a tool that converts cues, loops, playlists, crates, etc. between various DJ software for macOS. The fun part is that the DJ Conversion Utility was actually first called DJAY Conversion Utility because I wrote it for myself as an in-house script to convert my Traktor cues. I'm a Traktor user, that is my base DJ software, to Algorithms DJ, which was always my backup on iOS, on an iPhone or an iPad. And when other DJs saw that I had written this tool, they wanted it too, and that is where all this came from. That is what started this huge snowball, which totally went out of control because I never expected it to be as big as it has become. But hey, there is a need for it, obviously. And besides the DJ Conversion Utility, I have written a lot of other tools for DJs helping with collection management and collection conversion. So if you want to know more about that, check them out. www.atgr.nl is the website, but you can also ask it in the chat, of course, because hey, that is why we do this live stream. Like I said, the main subject for today will be Algorithms DJ, but that doesn't mean that we are restricted to Algorithm DJ. If you have a particular DJ tech question, just throw it in the chat and I can see if I can help you with it and maybe demonstrate how you can turn things around. Algorithms DJ, it was love at first sight when I saw it first like 10 years ago, I think, and that is nothing like it is right now. But when I saw that working on an iPad and being able to DJ on an iPad, that really blew my mind. But I was on Traktor and all my cues and loops and all my tracks were basically in Traktor, so I wanted to be able to go to DJ, so I wrote the DJ Conversion Utility, as I mentioned before. Long story short, Algorithms DJ has evolved. It has so many great features now, and so has the DJ Conversion Utility. As some of you might be aware, I am doing public betas of all my tools right now in anticipation of macOS Ventura. Those betas, you can download them for free if you start one of the apps you have and you go to the message box, there's the little envelope at the top right-hand corner. Then you get in the message box the download link to the beta and you can play with it. Are a lot of improvements. I really recommend the beta. In general, if I put out the beta, all the real nasty stuff is already killed, but it isn't just bug-free yet, or maybe it is. I don't know, but there are bugs that I'm not aware of because they have to be discovered first, and that's why they are betas. But betas with me are never like shady software, that they are already close to the final release if I put it in beta, because usually I know where the weaknesses are within the software, so that's what I test myself, so that's what I fix, but that doesn't mean that there are no surprises in it. Another thing to remember, I often forget to switch cameras if we are streaming together and I am totally into my story and telling you stuff and showing you stuff, and I think that you can see the screen right in front of me, while in truth you just see my face and the chat box. If that happens, please throw it in the chat. Throw it in the chat that I didn't switch the cam, because I don't want you guys to miss any of this stuff, because this is going to be a great show. First things first, Algorithms DJ has the ability to sync its database across various macOS devices using iCloud Drive. iCloud Drive is an option you can enable within iCloud. And under iCloud Drive, there is the option to sync with DJ. I had the problem that it never worked for me, but that is not as much Algorithm's problem as it is that I mess around a lot with all this stuff. So I put databases left, right, fore, after, which means that in the end of the day, Apple doesn't know what to sync anymore, because there are so many different versions going on. But I also heard from other people that syncing was kind of a problem for them. In general, syncing using iCloud is a very big black box. If you are Apple and you write a contact manager and you write a calendar on your Mac, of course, then it will work perfectly well. And that I use as well. But the moment documents are involved, databases are involved and stuff like that, I don't bother with it. So what I would first recommend to you guys is switch off iCloud Sync on any iOS device and on your macOS for DJ. If you want to use it for anything else, that's fine. But if you go to iCloud, there you have the button that you can set various options, and there you can choose switch on or off iCloud. If you think, hey, MixMasterG, why don't you show it to me? That is because if I go to iCloud, it reveals some personal information that I don't want to be on my screen. So sorry for that, folks. There is a video where I show this stuff. So if you want to see how to disable iCloud for DJ, you can see it right there. But in general, it is pretty straightforward if you are a macOS user. Now, how do I get everything back and forth? Philip Tan, good to see you, buddy. And welcome to the stream. First of all, you need to know what is stored where. And that is, in the case of DJ, pretty simple. Everything is stored in the central database that is located in the music folder. So if you go to your music folder right there, there is a folder named DJ right there. And if I open it up, you see a thing named the DJ Media Library. You see it right there. And it has a very long name. I can take that one away. And that is basically the database that contains your cues, your loops, your playlists, and all other stuff. What it doesn't contain is the analysis information. So the graphical representations of the waveform you see on your screen and the grid are not in that database. They are in a separate part. And that is the reason why you always have to reanalyze tracks, even if you did already. I am looking with Algorithm in a way to sync that as well. But right now, you can sync it across iOS devices and you can sync it across macOS devices, but you cannot cross sync it. You cannot sync from an iOS device to a macOS device. So to avoid confusion, I will not show that to you guys. But this database basically contains everything, which means the moment I go to DJ, like right here, let me put that in context for you guys. And I go to the DJ there and let's create a playlist. At the playlist, and we call that the test playlist. And then I put my openings tune in it. There you can see it is there. Now, if I quit DJ and if I rename this database, I have to make sure that DJ is quitted. Always important if you do tricks like this, make sure your software is totally quitted, stopped, not open anymore. And then you can mess with the stuff. So let's rename the DJ Media Library to something else, put a one in front of it, for instance, which means DJ cannot find it anymore. So DJ thinks that it is on a brand new system. And you can see that the playlist is gone. And it can work vice versa. So if I quit this again, and if I take this one away, and if I rename it back, all of a sudden my playlist will be back with the track in it, the cues and loops and everything else. So that is a way how you can move back and forth between databases. Now, why do you need to know this? You need to know this because this is the fundament, the base of syncing data across iOS and macOS. Right here I have laying in front of me my trustworthy iPad, which has my entire collection on it. If you are interested in getting mobile with your DJing, or for instance you want to go to the camping, or to a hotel or something, and you want to DJ on the way, DJ on an iPad is a great thing. Now the fun part is that the iPad Pro 12.9, this is an iPad Pro 12.9, the older generations work perfectly fine with DJ, and they are really, really cheap on things like Craigslist, Marktplaats, eBay. So you can get them secondhand for close to nothing, which means you get yourself a DJ system in a box. Later on, I will talk about going external with it. First, we are going to talk about the technicalities involved getting stuff from your Mac to your iPad and back. And then I have to dive into a problem. But it is very simple. You see this DJ media library right here. Now, if I start up a program called iFunbox, and that is freeware, you can Google it and you can download it for free. What iFunbox does is it gives you access to an iOS device without jailbreaking and stuff like that. You don't need to jailbreak. You can just access the data on your iOS device if it is not sandboxed. So there are some things that you cannot get to. You cannot cut through the context, for instance, and stuff like that. But stuff like the DJ database, you can get into, and you can find it under the app file sharing. And there you find DJ in my case. And if I double click it, then at the right, you see a dot algorithm folder and a user data folder. The dot algorithm folder is a hidden folder. You cannot normally see that, but because I take a shortcut and I use an iFunbox, I can see it. By the way, you don't require iFunbox if your macOS is compatible with your iOS. And right now that is not the case with me, because I'm on a Mojave computer. That is my production machine. And my iOS is on the latest device. So those two things don't communicate well together. But if you are on a compatible macOS, iOS, then you can do this all from the Finder or from iTunes. I will show you that in a minute too. But first, because I want to show some other stuff first, we are going to deep dive into how this stuff works. Let me show that. So if I go inside the user data, and normally that is the only folder you can see, you see there a DJ media library folder right here. Now, the thing you see here on the app on the Mac side of things and the thing you see there are the same thing. They are both the same DJ library. So, oh, hold on, my bad. Thank you, AG Flow. Let me switch that again. You see, that was pretty early on in the. All right, so let me take a shortcut and let me show that again, because otherwise you get really, really annoyed. All right, so right here in the music folder, we have the DJ folder. Right there, we have the DJ folder. And in the DJ folder, you find a thingy named DJ Media Library. It looks like a file, it's actually a folder. And that contains everything DJ. Now, if I fire up iFunbox, and like I said, if you Google it, you can download it for free, but I will also show you how to do this the official way using the music app later on. But first, we are going to do it like this. If I open it right here and I go to DJ, you see the user data right there. If I open the user data, you see backups. I usually delete those backups. If I right click it, I can say delete, and that saves up a lot of valuable storage information on your computer. I don't know why that backup is still mandatory. I think they should make it a toggle or an option, because there is for regular users no way to get that data back. But hey, who am I? Now, what we are going to do is we are going to drag this DJ media library right here on the desktop, because I will need it in a moment. And why I need it, I will show you right away. Because if I try to start up DJ on my iPad, it will refuse to start up. There is a problem with it that it takes close to forever to start up. Let me wait until this copy is finished and then I switch the screen again. There we are. So here we have the iPad. If I press the DJ icon, then DJ tries to start up, and you can already see this is taking too long. But hey, let's wait it out. Then you know exactly what's happening. And I saw other posts with users that has the similar problem, which are experiencing the same similar problem. So you see, now it quits somehow. It isn't really quitted. If I double click it on the home screen, then you can see that it's still open somehow. But if I then bring it to the front, nothing happens. If I swipe it up, trust me, the same thing will happen over and over again. In the past, it was possible that after 4 or 5 attempts, it would still start up. You can see that the screen is entirely black now, so nothing happens. In short, this is a problem, because if you rely on it, then hey, you have a problem. But lucky enough, I dove into this weekend, and I found what the problem is, why this is happening, why my DJ on iOS is not starting up at all. And I developed an app, or just created an app, to fix this. So you can see, it will not fly, nothing will happen. Now remember that let me switch the screen again. Do this one, please. Remember that I copied the DJ Media Library, that is right here. Let me place that one right into the DJ Media Library right there. And if I make this a little bit bigger, then you can see that this is a big one. This is almost 500 megabyte of data. Now, the odd thing is, if I start DJ on my macOS, which will use that database that doesn't work on iOS, it takes a while to start up. It takes a long while to start up because this is a big database. But hey, it will start up eventually and all my data will be there. So somehow, this is a problem on iOS, because on macOS this is functioning. And if I find a track, let's see if I can find a track to quickly load. I already know what I want as my focus track, because we are going to go back and forth between this. So then it's always good to have a focus track. Let's take the Mixmaster G. Where is it? There it is. And there you can see it has the cues. Indeed, 2 samples, one from last night, DJ Save My Life, and the other one is Rapper's Delight. Indeed. So that all works. So the database works on macOS and doesn't work on iOS. Now let me show you how we can fix it. And I wanted to show that because that also shows you how you move data across one device and another. So if I go to my applications, I made a script for it, or actually an app for it. Where is it? There it is. This very fixed DJ collection. I didn't give it an icon. I made it very straightforward and very simple. By the way, if you need this tool, it is on the DJ conversion utility beta, in the miscellaneous folder of the beta. You can find it. If you double click it, you get a warning what it will do. It will make a backup, and let me show that too in real time so you can see what is going to happen. So let's go to the DJ folder. So here we are. You can see that right there. You can see that there is that big DJ Media Library, which works perfectly fine on macOS, but doesn't work on iOS for some reason. Now let's click in the app, continue. Let's give it the usual OKs. You see that it is making a backup. It is already done. Now look at this. The size has been dramatically reduced, and everything is still there. All your cues, loops, playlists, everything is still there. And if I fire up the DJ conversion over algorithms DJ again, there we are. And let's see if I can quickly find that same test track. Is it in the history? Are we lucky today? No, it doesn't. You can see, by the way, that this is really my collection, because you can see it goes back to August 2020. So this is really going back a long time. But because I can, I'm going to find my Mixmaster G track sample, because after that we are going to put everything on the iPad, because that's where I need it. And that will fix also the issue of not working again. So let me find that a cappella track again. And let me just make an alias out of it. So in the next time I can find it a little bit easier. I'm not sure if I can drop an alias on it. No, that's not possible, right? Show original. You learn something on the fly, right? All right, and let's give it a third cue right here. And let's say the third cue. And we can now, by the way, assign colors to cues. So I can make this, for instance, a purple cue, or I can make this. If you click the little triangle in on the top of it, you can make it any color you like or you want. So you need to enable this for that. But hey, it works, and I think it's a great addition that you can do that now. And I wanted to show that too, because in a moment we are going to play with that as well. Another thing that is new in DJ that I wanted to show you guys is this. Why is my playlist not showing? All right. Let's make a playlist and let's put test, and let's put the, of course I closed my window too soon, show the original. That's why you make aliases, folks, to be able to very quickly demo stuff. You can, if you right click the thing now, say show me the color, and what is also new is play count. So both is very new and both is very useful. Let's move that a little bit to the top, and let's move that play count also a little bit there. And let's give the track a yellow color, for instance. So you can see there are some new toys inside Algorithms DJ, and the good part is my tools can use it. So we go into that a little bit later. What I now did is I made a playlist. I give this one a third cue. I quit this. And what I'm now going to do is the scary part. I open my DJ, music, DJ. I delete this file from my iPad. Remember, that's still iFunBox you are looking at. I delete it. Yes, I'm sure I want to delete it. And then I can pick this one up right here and move it right there. Wait for it to be copied. I'm going to trash. I always trash the backups if I see them on iOS. I'm fine with them on macOS, but on iOS I immediately trash them. They're just eating space, and you can see that I have a big collection, so that is eating up a lot of space. So if I go right now, you can see it starts up. It starts up very, very quick. Now let's see if it loads up that particular track, because it should be able to do. We are in the history. There is the test list. There is MixMaster G. And there we are. Does it load up? There it is loaded up. You can see it has three cues. So if I go right here, you can see the third cue. So all that information is right there. So that was how I fix my database. And just to prove you that I can throw the data back and forth around, I just added some extra stuff to it. So that was part one. Now let me show you, if you don't want to use iFunBox, but you want to stick to the official Apple tools, etc., how to do this. Let me quit DJ on my iPad. I'm going to connect it to the Mac Mini, which is running macOS Ventura, which is in the front of the office. So hold on a moment. You can see me walk and you can hear me walk. Passing Darth Vader, of course. Let's see. There it is. And I am waiting for it to appear on my screen. All right, that is, well, that is really quick. That works a lot quicker than that you do it on an Intel machine, I can tell you that. All right, let me show you guys how that stuff works, because that will show, that will give you a complete understanding of how you can sync your data between various devices. And I'm now going to do it the official way, but it really doesn't matter how you want to do it. You can do it either way. Let me sign into my Mac Mini. and then I will switch the screen again. Once it's there, hold on. View, we want the optimized quality and we want to have the wallpaper there. And then I can switch the screen and there we are. If you select the iOS device in the left column on a machine that is running Catalina or later, so this is for you guys who use Catalina or later, then you can get on the device. You don't need to have to sync your device with that particular Mac. This is not synced with the M1, it's synced with a different Mac, but I can still access the files I need to access. How do you do that? You go to the files segment. And whilst in the file segment you see DJ, if you click the little triangle in front of it, you will see the user data. Unfortunately, we cannot dive into it, so that means that you have to copy it. Let me take that one away because I did a little testing first, of course. And you can just drag it to the desktop and you can see right on in the bottom that it is already copying. You can see it copying right there. Now let me open my Finder on the M1, go to Music, go to DJ. There you see the old media library. Let's trash that. Let's trash the backups too. Why not? So we are copied. And then I take the DJ media library and put it into the DJ folder that is in the Music folder. So there you got it. So again, I moved it first to the desktop because I need to have the user data on the desktop. Then I open user data. I find the DJ Media Library, library folder. You open the DJ folder within Music and then you just drag it in there. Again, important, make sure that DJ is quitted before you do this. And also make sure that iCloud Drive is disabled for DJ. Two very important things. DJ must be closed and DJ must not use iCloud Drive. You must disable iCloud Drive in your system preferences on either iOS, macOS, wherever. Now, if I fire up DJ right here, and there you can see that indeed we have the test playlist that I made on this particular computer. And let's see if we can load it up. It cannot load it. Oh, it cannot find it. All right, let's load it up. It should be able to find it, but hey, we don't care if it doesn't remember the file path. There is the one. Let's make an alias out of it. And now I'm faced with the problem that there it is. Now it can find it. And you can see that the little yellow dot is in front of it. So I can load it up. I didn't even put it in it. All of a sudden it found it. And there you see. And the green third queue that I actually set on this computer. That wasn't set on the M1 where it is connected now. It is set and I just used my iPad to transfer it. So for fun and for giggles, let's give it a fourth queue. And let's edit it. The fourth queue. A yellow one, why not? And let's change the color to red. Why not? I quit Algorithms DJ. Now, in order to get the data back on my iOS device, things work a little bit differently because I am on an M1, but I go to that user data folder that is still on my desktop and I just throw away all the tracks or everything that is in there. Then below, let me do that step by step, we go to the Music folder, we go to the DJ folder, we go to that, hold down the Alt or Option key and then drag it to the user data, which will make a copy of it. That's all. Now I have in the user data right here, I have what I need. I can delete this one from my iPad. Again, make sure that DJ is closed on the iPad. Swipe it up so it is closed. Make sure the DJ is closed on the iOS device. And then I can just drag it over. Wait for it to appear. And then I walk back to the front of the desk and I will get my iPad back and I will show you everything is there again. So this is the smart and very fast way to sync your data across God knows how much iOS devices without using iCloud. The biggest benefit of this all is that it is no longer a black box. You know exactly what you are doing. Those DJ media library folders you can copy, make backups of, put on different spots if you like to. Not connected. Let me connect that. So you can make multiple copies of it, backups of it, whatever you want, but you now know where your data is at. I know that the latest version of my DJ library is right here on this iPad. Now let's see if it, yep, there we are. But it doesn't show it because it forgot that it could. Let me tell OBS what to do so you guys can also see what I'm doing. Where am I? All of a sudden it decided not to show it. Why not? Not good connected, I think. By the way, this, my friends, is that message that I get. You need to now, wadi wadi wadi, not now, and I don't mind. Now let me get back. Ah, there we are. So, no, there we are not. What I needed was this one, and I was playing with the settings of the. There we are. There we are. And then again, I'm greeted. You cannot see that on screen, but I'm greeted that there is a software update required. Always not now, because otherwise you are going to update your macOS. And I want to stick on macOS Mojave for as long as I can, because that is my favorite macOS version for various reasons. Now, if I start up DJ again, and you know the routine. And if I go to my test folder and I load my test track in, and then it should show a fourth queue, but I don't see a fourth queue. So maybe I didn't copy it over. I don't know. That's weird. But I'm sure it should be there. Anyway, this is how you do that stuff. So this is how you move data back and forth between various iOS devices, macOS devices. And it's a pretty clean way to do so. So this is what I highly recommend. Another thing, the good part about DJ on iOS is it works with a host of controllers and professional gear. You can use a Rain 1 with it, you can use a Rev 7 with it, you can use a CDJ 3000, a Nexus 2, whatever with it. It uses a lot of tools. Now, if you want to do that, if you want to use a controller with DJ, I like to use it just with an iPad screen because that is more than big enough for me. But if you want to use external devices, make sure you use this little thingy that is called the Apple Camera Adapter Kit. They come in two flavors, one with and one without a charge port. Make always sure that you've got one with the charging port. Don't go for the cheap Chinese knockoffs. They will not work, or they will let you down in midstream. And trust me, I've tried all the cheap Chinese knockoffs and they all failed me at one certain point. And then I bit the bullet and put down real cash and buy this thing from Apple. And this is with me for 3 years now. It never has failed me ever. So that is why I'm really saying use original, genuine Apple stuff if you want to do this. Another thing, if you use just an audio box, you can just connect an audio device or an audio box, a USB audio box to the iPad and tell DJ to use one channel for headphone output and one channel for master output, which means you have stereo monitors in your headphone and stereo out on your master instead of split, which I don't like. But if you want to do that, make sure you connect a powered hub to this thing. And in general, I try not to draw power from this connection at all. First of all, because this relies on your iPad power, it will draw from the battery, and even if there is a connector connected to it, that connector will need all its juice to charge the battery in the iPad, because the iPad 12.9 is a big power user if it's on, especially if the screen is bright, and especially if you're using Wi-Fi and stuff like that. So for that reason, be sure that you can use a powered USB, so this doesn't need to provide any juice to the USB devices you're going to use. Trust me, this is valuable information because otherwise you can get into troubles with it. Let me have a drink first. Now, once I've told you how that works with the DJ database, I've showed you how to fix the database if you have startup issues on your iOS device. Now let me show you some real cool new stuff that is possible with the new version of the DJ Conversion Utility, the beta. I uploaded it this morning, so if you haven't downloaded the beta, the latest beta lately, go to the link that is inside the message box, and download the latest beta. Unfortunately, I cannot provide an update mechanism for the beta, so you always have to check if there is a newer version available. Another thing that I updated this week was the iTunes collection tool, especially if you are on Catalina or later, then you want to check out the beta of the iTunes collection tool because there are some really good improvements inside of it. Enough about that, let's go DJ Conversion Utility and let's go DJ Conversion Utility Beta with Algorithms DJ and all the stuff we can do with it. I start out with an empty DJ library. Like I told you, if you just mess with the name, then you will be fine. So if I start up DJ now, I am entirely empty, which is what I want, because I want to do this on a very small DJ database, so at least we don't have to wait for everything to get back to it. Let's fire up Rekordbox. I'm going to do this, folks, from Rekordbox to DJ and from DJ to Rekordbox. If you want to go beyond that, of course, you can do that with the DJ Conversion Utility. You can even do it with Denon gear if you use the Denon Conversion Utility together with the DJ Conversion Utility. But for the sake of simplicity, let's keep it to Rekordbox and just show you how you go back and forth between Rekordbox with DJ. Let me clean this mess up a little bit because I have no idea what I'm looking at. Like this. Let's create a new playlist and let's go to export mode because that is the mode I like to work in for stuff like this. There we are. And then let's make playlist one. And let's make an extra playlist. All right. That extra playlist, by the way, is a tip. I had some users of the DJ Conversion Utility who were complaining, listen, Mixmaster G, why is my entire Rekordbox collection always converted? Reason for that was they just had one single playlist, and that one single playlist didn't contain their entire collection. It just contained a few tracks. But the problem is if you have one playlist in Rekordbox and you select that single playlist for conversion, as far as the DJ Conversion Utility is concerned, you selected all the playlists in your collection because there is just one. So it will convert all the tracks even if they are not part of that playlist. So for that reason, I always say make two playlists and, or at least two playlists, and you will see then it will work a lot better. I know it is a little bit silly, but hey, it is how it works. Let's load up some tracks. Let's analyze those tracks. Remember that we are on a brand new DJ database. I renamed the old one, so there is no prior information inside that database. Let's load up this track. Let's give it some cues. One cue there. One cue there, and why not? One cue there, and then let's set a loop here. I know it doesn't make any sense what we are doing, but hey, this is just for demonstration, right? So we don't care. Now, cues in DJ can have a color, loops cannot have a color, but everything can have a name. So let's do that. Let's make this a red. A red one, let's make this blue one. I still hate how this has changed. It was so much easier in the past where you could just click on it. And let's make this one, I think it's pink. But hey, I'm a guy, pink. Like this. All right, and then let's give the track a color too, because we can convert that too nowadays. Colors are not there, so let's turn them on. And then I have to drag them all the way to the front, of course, why not? Where did you leave my color? This is something they need to fix too. My friends for Pioneer, are you paying attention if I enable a thing? I want to see it. I want to see that I enabled it. Color, there it is. And then this is always a fight to get the color inside. We give it a red dot. So our test track has a red dot, simple as that. Now, these tracks are not analyzed in DJ yet. As you might know, before you can give tracks, cues and loops in DJ, they need to be analyzed by DJ. Otherwise, they will be part of DJ or they will be signaled that they need to be analyzed. Right now, let me export this collection to XML format, record box. Here we go. And let me just show you the procedure if you don't do that. And let me name that loop, loop, like this. Let me export it again, because if you change something, you need to export the XML again. And that's why we like to keep this small. And playlist one is playlist two is the playlist that we are working in. So just for my own reference, let's fire up the DJ conversion utility, which will be the new beta. I am not sure if I started up DJ, so it needs to have, I don't think so, but we can double check that. Hold on. Ah, yeah, I did. Because if there is no DJ library, then the DJ conversion utility will not make it possible to convert to it. So we go from Recordbox. Now in the new beta, we are at 5.7.7 as you can see. If I enable DJ, iTunes will be automatically enabled. Reason for that is that playlists are not created in DJ, they are created in iTunes. Now don't worry, the DJ conversion utility has some safeguards in it to prevent duplicates from appearing in your collection. So don't worry about that all, it is all taken care of. And then iTunes is still the best way, iTunes or its successor music is still the best way to get your data across various devices, and that's what we want. And that will work by far the best. So that's the reason why I still do that. We need playlist two, as we might know, because playlist one was empty. And this is what I meant. If you just have one playlist and you click that single playlist, then as far as the DJ conversion utility is concerned, you selected all the tracks. So, hey, that's not good. No need to see the playlist because I already know what happens. You need to go to the music or iTunes part of it. Then you go to the DJ conversion utility from Recordbox, analyze these in DJ first. And they need to be analyzed first because they weren't analyzed. You can see there is no color information there. By the way, we need to enable that too. So let's enable that too. We want color. We want that in the front. And then what is also new, by the way, is a play count, which will be converted. So that is important information too. So let's put that to the front too. So we need to do the conversion again, because now the tracks have been analyzed. So now they will receive their converted data. And if you want a shortcut, if you don't want to do that twice, then simply make sure that the tracks are analyzed. You can just drag and drop them from Recordbox inside DJ, and then you can analyze them all the way down. So it is just a matter of what you want to do. Hold on, we are coming from Recordbox. We want to go to DJ. You can see that iTunes is automatically enabled. I will disable it now because the playlist is already in iTunes, so I don't need it there a second time. So let's go. Philip 10, is it possible to use something like automated to run DJCU on a schedule, that is syncing certain playlists from a Recordbox database to a DJ library on iPad every night? No, and there are various reasons for that, Philip 10, but you don't want that either. You don't want that to happen at all. You want to have a human controlling this workflow. because if you want to do that automatically, then there are all kinds of implications for it. But there is a very smart way to do this, given that iTunes is your integral collection manager. If iTunes is your integral collection manager, which I am a huge advocate of, then there is a way to make this very simple. And I will show that in a moment, especially coming from Rekordbox. Or from Serato, by the way, or from Traktor, it works all the same. So right now the playlist is empty, which means everything has been analyzed. And if we go into playlist 2, there you can see that indeed the red dot was converted. And if we load it up, you can see that your tracks are there too, or the cues are there too. And if we go to the loop, and you always have to find that loop by clicking that thing and then go to the saved loops. And there is loop-de-loop. And you can see that it's also smartly placed across the track. So everything is converted from Rekordbox to DJ. Now, Philip 10, if you just want to convert changes, so you changed, let's say you synced from Rekordbox last week and you want to do that again, what you need to use is the Rekordbox 6 to XML tool. It comes free with the DJ Conversion Utility. It is in the miscellaneous folder of the DJ Conversion Utility disk. And you need to use that. Let me show you how you use that. If you press the, I think the Option key, I always forget. It's the Option key, the Alt or Option key on your keyboard, and then double click Rekordbox 6 to XML, something funny will happen. Namely this, you are entering the modification date selection mode, which means you can enter a date, any date, and it will only take the tracks that were modified or added to Rekordbox at or after that date. So basically only your changed tracks, and it will create one playlist out of it. Now, because there was not much in my Rekordbox database, I can say today here, or let's, yeah, why not? Let's take 12/12/07/2022 there. It will create that Rekordbox XML right there, but I didn't change much, of course. So right now it is a kind of useless exercise because all the data is already in DJ. But hey, I have an idea. Let me reset the DJ database and let me show you how that then works. No, we don't need that. Let's go back to this and let's go to DJ. And I take the shortcut now. So I just delete the DJ database. I fire it up again. Now the tracks are still in the DJ Conversion Utility folder. This one is empty, remember, but this one is not empty. Those are the same tracks. They are just in a different playlist, but those are the same tracks. I can analyze them. You can see that the Maneskin track doesn't have, or I don't know which one I used, but the one with the dot is not there because it has no converted data yet. So let's quit DJ Pro here. Let's fire up the DJ Conversion Utility. I have to wait for that. Oh, damn. Oh, I hold on, let me double check. Yeah, I did take the backup off. We come from Rekordbox. Now, watch this. It is using a file named Rekordbox RB6 XML. That is the XML file created by X26. And we want to go to DJ. That file only contains one folder, namely the folder or the playlist. One playlist named Tracks Added or Modified After the Date We Gave It. You see? There we are. Tracks Added or Modified After 12/07/2022. That's the one we need. And this is why it's so important to use iTunes as your universal collection manager for your playlist, etc. Because I can access those tracks from DJ without having them in DJ, as you could see. And right now everything is converted. No, I don't want that. I want to go to test. No, I want to go to this one. Let's dive deep into it. And there you can see that also in playlist 2, it has the queue, it has the data, everything is there. So that is your real-time sync from Rekordbox. I told you can do the same thing from Serato or from tractor. Let me show that too. Then we have everything covered. Of course, those tracks are not in Serato, but if I fire up the DJ conversion utility, where am I? There am I. And you go from tractor, you can do exactly the same thing. You can do advanced selection method, select only the tracks that were modified or added, and there's the date. So that's how you do it in a conversion from tractor. The same from Serato. You can hit that one, and there you can say select the tracks modified or added after a given date. So you can do that with tractor, Serato, and Rekordbox. And in case of Rekordbox, you need Rekordbox 6.2 XML, my tool, because that has that option inside of it. So that will make sure that you can keep it, and that also means that you don't need overnight, etc. Because let's say you add maybe 30 tracks a week, that will be done in 5 minutes. You can wait for it. So that is the most efficient way to do this kind of stuff. What I also created, or what I also did, is I made it possible to go from DJ to Rekordbox, or to any other software if you like. Let's focus on the tracks at hand, so let's focus on this one. Let's change the color for the cue to yellow, and let's give it an extra cue right there, and let's give that cue, the color is fine, let's give it, this is a DJ cue that is set to, and we can do the same with an extra loop, why not? We are there anyway, so let's go to the saved loops, and let's create a saved loop at the cue point. The DJ loop. Notice, by the way, that if you add something and you select it, this is in mirror image. I don't know why it is, but it turns out to be. All right, so I did add that one. Now, in order for this to work, tracks need to be in a DJ playlist or in a history playlist. Right now, we are looking at the iTunes part of DJ. The DJ part of DJ shit is this one. Either you have a playlist there or you have a history there. Now, the moment you start to play a track, let me turn this off, or otherwise we get into trouble, and then it should come into the history list. I don't see it being, why not? There was a smart way to do this, but hey, I forgot it. So add playlist, test, and then I'm going to do this the old fashioned way because I have no idea how to do this smart way. So if I fire it up right here, and we go to the playlist right here, and we take the Maneskin track. There it is. Oh, it wasn't Maneskin, it was something else. What did I use? Hold My Hand by Gaga. Oh, all right. Then we take that one. The Hold My Hand track by Gaga. And you can see that because you do this all from iTunes, you always have the same data there. So this is the same track as I just loaded with the DJ loop in it and with the cues, etc. So I did manage that. Let's quit this and let's fire up the DJ conversion utility again. Where am I at? There we are. I'm waiting for it to fire up as usual. Then this time we come from DJ. Leave everything default, that is just fine. Start the conversion. And it will tell us that there is no history because somehow it didn't put it in the history, but we want the test playlist anyway. So we just convert that one. And DJ conversion utility will convert this. We'll automatically start up X26 XML to Rekordbox 6 to get the information into Rekordbox 6. And that's running right here, as you can see. And after that, all the data is inside my Rekordbox collection. So this is how you can sync basically everything with everything again, including cues colors, including play counts, stuff like that. You don't see the play count updated in iTunes, by the way, because that is not a common tag, but it is updated in other stuff. And you can see that right now it is yellow. We've got all the things there. We've got the extra DJ loop. We've got the loop-de-loop from DJ, the DJ cue I set. The load cue, by the way, is an interesting one. A load cue is a cue that is set under the DJ cue button. Let me show that, because a lot of people forget about that. And it is really powerful too, because DJ saves the load cue position. So if you have this track here, right here, this is the load cue. So right now, this is the load cue, but you can say, no, I want this to be the load cue. And that means that if you convert right now, that you will have this cue named load cue inside your workflow. So there are some nice tricks you can do with this, as you can see. That is all new in the DJ Converse Utility Beta. Like I said, if you want to have the beta, fire up the DJ Converse Utility or any other of my tools, because every tool is updated. And I really, really urge you to use the updated versions, which I still need to make a lot of tutorials for, which is next on the list. By the way, I will bring these features to the DJ Conversion Utility Streaming as well. The DJ Conversion Utility Streaming is basically what you see right here, but then for tracks on Beatport Link, BeatSource Link, and Tidal. But that will take some time. And because the DJ Conversion Utility Streaming has not as big a user base as the DJ Conversion Utility, it isn't high on my priority list, but it will get there. So we will get there. Just want to, some stuff first to do. This is that message box if you click it. And underneath there, you can find the beta. And if you scroll more down, then you find the download link to the beta, and really use that beta, folks, because it is so much powerful and so much more fun than the regular version. So I really, really recommend you to use the beta. Are there any questions? Then please drop them in the chat, because this was what I wanted to discuss with you guys. This was the thing that I wanted to share with you guys. But if there are other questions, or if you want to know some more stuff about this, just ask me, because that is where we do, why we do this. Ask me anything, live streams, and I'm more than happy to answer them. So for that, we will wait a little while. And if there are no questions, then I will very slowly go into the night, finish some other stuff that I need to do, and hopefully see you next week. By the way, I expect to do a pop-up workflow stream this week. I don't know when, because if I do those, then I need at least 3 hours of time, because my workflow is not taking 3 hours, but all the explanation and stuff around it is taking 3 hours. And usually when I'm close to release of new toys, I always do the workflow video, because that is for me my final beta test to see that everything works the way it's supposed to work. So keep an eye open for that. If I do it, it will be during the European afternoon, most likely around 2 p.m. in the European afternoon. Don't really set a date for it. I don't know when and if I'm going to do it, but I suspect that I will do it. I've got some tracks that I want to add to my collection. And hey, why not do that with the new betas, just to test them out. I don't see any more questions popping in, which means I'm going to close the stream for this week. It was great to have you guys with me again. If you are watching this on demand, then hey, why wasn't you live at the stream? But still, don't forget to give this video the thumbs up and to like, subscribe, and all that other good stuff. If you have got questions, then please ask them in the remarks under the video. And maybe I will come back to them in the next Ask Me Anything live stream and address them there. For now, thank you all for watching. Mixmaster G is signing off on YouTube and Facebook. I'm not going to rate anybody today. So, hey, we are just signing off. Thank you for being